What's up, guys? Welcome to Men About Cake. I'm your host, Joshua John Russell, and this week the Halloween shenanigans continue. I'm gonna build a two-tiered vanilla cake filled with Halloween rainbow buttercream and finished with a fat little monster who's sleeping because he ate too much cake. You guys ready?
Ooh.
Let's do it! I'm gonna break down an 8-inch vanilla cake. You guys know where these recipes are, in the eye or the description box below. This one has some weird craters in it.
Yeah, I was just about to say, what's up with the Swiss cheesecake?
I don't know. That's odd. I must have whipped the egg whites a little bit aggressively. Whoa! Looks like the moon. Now I'm gonna fill this with some Halloween colored buttercream.
So why are these Halloween colors, Joshua?
What do you mean, why are they Halloween colors? Like, I got orange, obviously. Dark purple is a Halloween color, and so is like this monstery alien green.
Okay.
It's like Halloween rainbow.
I just assumed Halloween was sort of black and orange.
No, there's all kinds of colors.
Yeah, silly me going with history.
All right, I'm gonna get this guy in the cooler to set up, then we'll trim the sides, crumb coat, final coat. Second trip to the cooler, and we'll do the final coat.
Oh yeah.
Now I'm gonna do a color dragging technique with four of my Halloween colors, and then we're gonna finish it with some Halloween graffiti sprinkles. These are so cute. They have little ghosts and bats. Look. You're gone. Okay, we'll start with the purple. Just gonna pipe some along the bottom here.
Rob, do you even know what color dragging is?
Yeah, Rob.
I do not know what color dragging is, but.
This guy.
Just wait to have your mind blown.
Oh, do you know a movie I just saw?
What?
A Quiet Place.
That movie scared the crap out of me.
I hate to tell you, but I saw one of those things, like the alien things from the movie.
No, you did not.
It was in the studio earlier.
No, stop. No scary this year.
What do you think happened to Brandon?
Brandon would be the one in the quiet place that's like, what, we have to be quiet? And
hey, pass me the spam.
Yeah, I had to watch a happy movie after that because I couldn't go to bed. Now we're gonna put some sprinkles along the bottom.
And we're definitely the loudest people in this building, so if there's one place that monster would be.
That's true. He would come straight to Studio B. This cake's heavier than it looks. There's just ghosts and bats flying everywhere. Get all this off the bottom here. I just like messed my cake all up with this. I'm gonna fix it. It just keeps sliding. I don't know what's happening. There's a sprinkle underneath it, and it has wheels! All right, now we're gonna put it back on, and I'm just gonna go like, ugh.
There's a wrinkle in my sprinkle, and it's making me wiggle.
Stressed out. All right, now we're gonna make our monster. I'm gonna sculpt the monster out of modeling chocolate. So I have modeling chocolate pieces here. They're just in white. I'm gonna paint him after I get all his details.
Ooh, Joshua.
Yeah.
Your Dexter kit is on the table.
It is. This is my sculpting kit. So I have like all kinds of sculpty tools. I don't know, I collect tools. I like tools a lot.
All of a sudden you started wearing gloves. You started worrying about where the FBI is.
What's up with the plastic wrap back here?
You'll see. So I wear gloves because it's easier to smooth the chocolate and then you don't get your fingerprints in the chocolate too. So anyways, here's his body. So I'm just kind of make him like a fat little belly. And then at the end we'll put like cake crumbs and then we'll claw into the cake. It's gonna be so cute. This is actually a trend people are doing with unicorns and I think it's adorable. So I thought, let's do a Halloween one.
Hey Joshua, you want to hear some viewer questions and comments?
Yes, I do.
All right, Rita Carnes.
What's up, Rita?
I think we've done one from Rita before, even.
Is she invited to dinner? Is it all caps?
It's not all caps.
Okay, well, then she's invited for appetizers, and she's got to go.
Hey, guys. Just wanted to say thank you. I made my husband's 40th birthday cake this weekend using your chocolate cake recipe.
Nice.
Best cake ever! Sure Stevens says, have you considered releasing an album of Mac music and poetry?
Every day.
I'll do it when I glue it as a family favorite. Winky smiley face. That's sing it more than I care to admit.
That's my favorite too. I'm gonna get them up on the cake stand. This is gonna be our final cake stand. This will be our actual cake, but I just put a styrofoam here so I can noodle him and not mess up our cake. Once he's done, we'll take this off and then stack the cake. Come on, buddy.
Who were you most scared of? Like, what movie character were you most scared of when you were growing up?
That's such a good, somebody else go. Tommy, go.
Easy. Old guy in Pet Sematary.
Oh.
He wasn't even like a bad guy or anything. He was just like very creepy. Just like, don't do that. Don't bury your cat there.
Mean guy from Dennis Menace. Really, really scared me.
So you went bully. Yeah. Not like
that is a horror movie. Kid's all by himself.
Rob, what was yours?
Say Patrick Swayze in Ghost.
Did you see that movie? He was a really nice ghost.
It terrified me.
I can't compete with that. That's the best answer ever. I want to take that answer. I want to know what you guys were scared of growing up in the movies. Put it in the comments below. Look at him. Now we gotta put his arms on. I wanted to do the hair first because the arms are gonna come across his belly. It'd be hard to get in there. He ate so much, his arms fell off. That happened to me once. More fur. He's a pretty good shape, and we're gonna do some ears and some little horns. What should his ears look like? Maybe the pointy. So we'll make like a little carroty thing. Oh.
My ear!
He doesn't have a mouth yet.
Oh.
To paint this guy, I'm gonna use powdered food color. I have some red and some orange. I have some diluted confectioner's glaze. I'm gonna kind of stipple it on so I can get into all the little cracks of his fur. And then we have some black for his hooves and for his horns. All right, now I'm gonna make him a little tongue with some pink fondant and then two little sleepy eyes with some black fondant. He's so full. I made a top tier that was similar to the bottom tier. Now I'm gonna stack and then put some glaze around the bottom tier.
Joshua! The monster's here! You gotta keep talking. Just go ahead and keep talking, it should be fine.
All right, so I'm just putting these bubble tea straws in! struggle with cakes today. They don't want to do anything. Lazy cakes. I'm gonna grab my piping bags and I'm gonna make this same technique along here. Okay, now I'm gonna dig into the cake to make it look like the monster's been eating it, and then I'm gonna put a little bit of some crumbs and maybe icing around his mouth as well with a paintbrush. Guilty. Our fat monster cake is complete, and I think he turned out super cute. Remember guys, my friends from Blueprint put together some awesome Halloween concepts. I'll put everything in the description box below. While you're down there, hit subscribe as well. And next week is our last Halloween cake. We're doing a zombie. It's gonna be awesome. Let's eat her. We're going to take a nap like him.
That's not funny. No letter from Brandon this week, guys.
No? Don't tell him this, but I kind of miss him. He's super snarky, and sometimes it's really funny, but I don't laugh. Well, to be honest, you won't actually see the butt because he'll be up against the cake.
But I'll know that my butt is white. It's like when you tan in the tanning bed and you get the cheeks tan, even though no one's gonna see them.
I love this monster goes to the tanning bed.
Yeah, I'm not naturally this red.
Why was that so funny?